My name is G. Shekhar from HIMT Chennai. Today, the topic I'm going to discuss is about decarbonization of shipping industry. Of late, you must have seen many webinars on this subject. Basically, it is new amendments that is coming in MARPOL Annex 6. If you look at now the new terminology like EEXI and CII and ratings, CII rating of an existing ship, these are the new things that is happening. If you see in last MEPC 75, many new suggestions were given, and MEPC 76 took place in middle of June 2021, and IMO, the MEPC committee, has come out with new amendments. If you look at chapter 4 of MARPOL Annex 6, where the regulations on energy efficiency is given, we had chapter 4. Now additional new regulations are being brought in through these amendments. So let me share some slides with you. So today we will just look at how this new changes on energy efficiency is going to take the shipping industry to new heights, where the IMO is now focusing on having zero carbon emission. So IMO Environment Committee approves amendments to cut ships emission, and this you are aware of, chapter 4 of MARPOL Annex 6 has been added sometime back in 2013. You will see applicable EEDI application to all new ships delivered after July 2015. So EEDI is a known fact now, and also ship energy efficiency management plan, and we also talk about energy efficiency operating index for all ships. So attained EEDI and required EEDI, these are the terms we are well aware of. Basically, when you talk about energy efficiency, we talk about how to reduce the fuel consumption, because the bunker fuel what we use on board is originating from fossil fuel. So when it is a hydrocarbon, you call it IFO, 180, 380, MGO or MDO. Basically, being a hydrocarbon, it is bound to give out carbon dioxide. So how to reduce? As you can see here, EEDA reflects the amount of CO2 generated per ton mile. So if you want to reduce greenhouse gases, the main greenhouse gas coming out from the shipping industry is carbon dioxide. So how to bring down carbon dioxide? That means you need to consume less fuel. So what are the factors that contribute to bring out more greenhouse gas emission from the shipping industry? So to control CO2 levels emitted for future ships by encouraging improvements in ship design. So these are the regulations, you know, which are already there in chapter 4, regulation 20, we can say 21, 22, and 22 has been added later, collection and reporting of ship fuel oil consumption data. Now this is a mandatory requirement for all ships above 5000 gross tonnage. Basically, this is IMO's ship fuel oil consumption database. We'll collect the data for all ships above 5,000 gross tonnage, and annual basis, IMO will be in a position to collect data and compare how much was the fuel consumption from the shipping industry year-wise. So the IMO also gives what they call statement of compliance to the individual ship when the fuel collection data has been sent to IMO. And if you look at this, achieving the goals of initial IMO greenhouse gas strategy. So International Maritime Organization has got initial strategy, short term and long term. So the requirements is a mix of technical, how the ship is built and what options can be brought in constructing a ship, so that the resistance can kept can be kept reduced so that consumption becomes less, so that CO2 emission becomes less. So technical issues, operational, how the ship is being operated. Basically, while operating the ship, design makes a difference. What type of fuel we use makes a difference. If you look at this specific slide, you can just see some of the operational and innovative solutions applicable to ships. Now, ships are being dried out with air bubbles below the keel strake. What for? Again, to reduce the friction. So, if you look at the various measures, how much is the approximate greenhouse gas reduction potential? As you can see, starting from here, extensive speed optimization, it brings down almost 75% of reduction of CO2. Here, concept, speed and capability, reduce speed, then less fuel consumption, then less CO2 emission. Hull and superstructure design aspect, the type of bulbous bow, profile of the bulbous bow, that makes a difference. Energy management at every level, voyage optimization, and fleet management, logistics and incentives. What are the types of fuel? Is it biofuel we are looking at? Are we using hydrogen? Or are we going to use fuel cells? Or is it going to be LNG? Or is it going to be ethane? Ships have come out with ethane fuel and also methanol fuel. Ships have come out with dual fuel diesel engine installation with this type of fuel. So that brings down your CO2 level roughly about 25 to 30%. So LNG, LPG and electric propulsion power, and of course your optimizing your propeller efficiency. Many things are being looked at, you know, when the new ship is being designed, or for an existing ship, what are the new changes that we can bring in, you know, the design, the technical issue, that is what is your EEXI for the existing ship is looking at. So, as far as the design, some of them already I have just covered. As you can see, reducing lightship weight or innovative solutions, I just now mentioned air bubbles that reduces the friction, optimizing propeller efficiency, and of course, reducing speed reduction. Of course, many ships, you know, if you run it on economical speed, naturally the fuel consumption, thereby CO2 emission will go down. So, greenhouse gas emission reduction will occur. So, using renewable power source, and we see now ro-ro ships with solar panels and cruise liners with solar panels, and using, exploiting the wind energy, low carbon fuel, just now I have mentioned, and waste heat recovery units, and of course, shaft generators installation, even for the existing ship for optimizing. So, if you look at this particular slide in MARPOL Annex 8, they are looking at the reduction factor. How the planning is going to be for different type of ships. If you look at bulk carrier or a gas carrier or any type of ship in this slide, if you see, over a period like phase 1, phase 2 or phase 3, they are looking at, you know, 10% CO2 emission reduction compared to what it was in 2008. Then here 20% and then 30% from 2025. You know, that's how the plan was. But then through MEPC committees, they have now reduced it, or you can say advanced the date. If you see in this column, third column, it is given 1st January 2025. Shipping industry or IMO is looking at bringing down the CO2 emission reduction by 30%. But that has been now advanced. As you can see here, application of EEDI phase 3 reduction factors brought forward from 2025, they have advanced it to 2022. So, as you can see here, energy efficiency design index foresees gradual improvement in energy efficient ship design and building. It is not only the fuel, a specific fuel consumption of the engine we are looking at. It is on the whole as a ship, the ship design inclusive, applies to new build ships only. As you can see, we'll enter into force 1st April 2022. So, wherever the red line, red circle is there, if you see here, phase 3, it's not first, it's not 25 now, it is now 22. That's what it is. 3 years they have brought in. Again, for the same reason. Now, the new things for the existing ship, what they are looking at, it was a draft amendment which in MEPC 76, they have brought out this amendment now. So, set of amendment includes technical requirement to reduce carbon intensity, new energy efficiency, existing ship index, EEXI, this I mentioned it earlier, and operational carbon intensity reduction requirements based on a new operational carbon intensity indicator. These are the two terms that we need to be familiar with. So, the dual approach, the EEXI is applicable to all ships above 400 gross tonnage. Your CII applies to all ships above 5,000 gross tonnage. So, both technical, EEXI looks after the technical issue, how the ship can be retrofitted if possible. It's a bit complex for an existing ship. And for example, installation of a shaft generator, installation of some equipments which can exploit wind energy, that type of issues here, technical and operational measures, how the ship operates. That includes even including the speed of the ship. So they have brought out two new terms like attained and required EEXI, very similar in terms like your EEDI. So the attained, as you can see, calculated for ships of 400 gross tonnage above, in accordance with different values set for ship types and size categories. IMO is now coming out with many guidelines for doing all that. Energy efficiency of the ship compared to a baseline. As you can see, ships are required to meet EEXI required, which is based on a required reduction factor relating to the EEDA baseline. So with, taking EEDA baseline, they are just looking at expressing it as a percentage, how much reduction it's going to be. Now, this what you are looking at is your latest MEPC. This was done in June 2021, just about 2 months back. So here, as I have said earlier, short-term measures to reduce greenhouse gas emission, amendments to MARPOL Annex 6, entry into force 1st November 2022. This is what they have decided. So what are the things they are looking at? Calculation and verification of EEXI for existing ship. Strength of ship energy efficiency management plan. You can say the SEEM is going to get enhanced, or you can call it enhanced or strengthened SEEM, where the CII rating has to be indicated. Introduction of rating mechanism, that means every ship will be rated. What is their, with reference to CO2 emission, where do they stand? That rating mechanism we will look at in coming slides. Linked to the operational carbon intensity indicator. So, they are now bringing in Chapter 4 new regulations. Earlier you saw, now these are the additional new regulations like 23 and 25. Here, as you can see, various ship types are given above 400 gross tonnage. Shall calculate the attained EEXI, and this shall result equal or less than the required EEXI calculated as 1 minus Y by 100 multiplied by EEDI. This value is given, required one by IMO already. And this Y factor, reduction factor is Y, specific for each ship type, bulk carriers, tankers or gas carriers, whatever it is. The verification of ships attained EEXI shall take place at the first annual intermediate renewal survey of IAPP certificate or initial survey of IEEC certificate. This IEEC certification is given when there is compliance of requirements of Chapter 4 of MARPOL Annex 6, whichever is first on or after 1st January 2023. That means the existing ships are to be ready to undergo the survey or the technical file or whatever it is, to get it done before 2023. For those ships already having a verified attained EEDI, for ships of this size, this type, the value may be taken as the attained EEXI if it is equal to or less than the required EEXI. In this case, the attained EEXI shall be verified based on the EEDI technical file. I think this we are all familiar now. EEDI technical file. And look at the new regulation, regulation number 26 now. Now here, what do they say? On or before 1st January 2023, the above listed ship types, you know, with addition, as I have said, propulsion of 5,000 gross tonnage and above, engaged in international voyages, shall include in the SEEM. These are the additional requirements to be added in the contents of your SEEM. a description of the methodology that will be used to calculate the ship's attained annual operational carbon intensity indicator and the process that will be used to report this value to the ship's flag administration. Required annual operational CII for the next 3 years. An implementation plan documenting how the required annual operational CII will be achieved during the next 3 years. A procedure for self-evaluation and improvement. So that means your SEAM is going to be added on with these additional factors. So confirmation of compliance shall be provided by the administration and retained on board prior to January 2023. The SEAM of the ship shall be subject to verification and company audits. So the responsibility is more for the companies to implement so that the administration survey goes without any issues. So operational carbon intensity indicator, a new regulation here they are bringing in. This is called Regulation 29. So here again, the above listed ship types, what do they see? They say here from 2023, after the end of each calendar year, calculate the attained annual operational CII over a 12-month period. That means from 1st January to 31st December. That means in each year, in that calendar year, and electronically report it to administration within March of each calendar year. Calculate the required annual operational CII, 1 minus Z divided by 100 multiplied by carbon intensity indicator rating, CIIR, where the annual reduction factor is a flat rate for all ship types. So the IMO has decided 5% in 23, 7% in 24. Of course, main guidelines have been given in this MEPC resolution number so and so in that particular year. So for various years, as and when the year advances, 23, 24, 25, 26, you will find the reduction factor Z value changes, and eventually, according to IMO guidelines, they have come out how they are fixing up this. The administration or RO shall verify the attained annual operational CII against the required annual operational CII, and then they give a rating, carbon intensity rating. Now they rate the ship, existing ship, into five categories, A, B, C, D, or E. The middle point of rating level C shall be the value equivalent to the required annual value. Ship rated D for 3 consecutive years or rated as E shall develop a corrective action plan. In case, that means what? A, B, C is good. A is very good, B is next, and C is you are just on the line, on the border. If you get D for 3 consecutive years, because every year you are going to carry out this survey, or if you are rated E, then you need to develop a corrective action plan to achieve the required annual operational CII2. You need to achieve this. Such a plan shall be included in the SEAM, which shall be submitted to the administration for verification within 1 month after reporting the attained annual operational CII. As you can see here, that means every ship is going to be rated. Every year you are going to have a survey, and based on the emission, the ships which emit less CO2 will be given a rating A, then comes B, then comes C. Up to A, B, C you are all right, and in case if you get D or E, then there is a corrective plan. So basically, when you are looking at your IMO has set 2030 as the target date for reducing ships' carbon emission by 40%. One of several upcoming decarbonization ambitions. This is what I mentioned earlier, decarbonization of the shipping industry. So basically, we are looking at CO2 emission. So if you look at the last line here, owners can then implement technical measures to adjust their vessel's emission to the required level. Now, what are the various technical issues the ship owner options are there in front of the ship owner for improving EEXI? One is engine power limitation, ECS, but then that is going to cost commercially. Change in fuel type from MDO to LNG, for example. This is again for an existing ship, it's going to be a bit complex, and you need to look at the cost and benefit analysis on that. And look at propeller retrofit. I don't think this is the big issue, but then redesign propeller so that your axial thrust is improved and you get a benefit of 10% there. installation of shaft generator for those type of ships where shaft generators are not there, you'll get about 5%. Installation of energy saving devices like wake equalizing duct and other things, maybe will give you a benefit of about 4%. And rotor sails, trying to exploit the wind energy may give you around another 3.8% or 4%. And 10% increase in transport capacity. So dead weight. So these are the things, So as you can see, engine power limitation will be the key measure to get improved EEXI requirements. So that besides the desired effect of reduced fuel oil consumption, throttling will also result in lower maximum speed of your vessel. So that means what is happening? Your speed will come down. So to counteract this effect, a retrofit of your propeller is to be recommended so that the propeller optimization or propeller efficiency improvement will give you a benefit. So that precise decision designing is required. A new operating point on the engine in the propeller curve, if you look at, this will reduce fuel consumption by about 14% or increase the reference speed of your ship. So your EEXI value will improve. This even opens a possibility to reduce the engine power limitation slightly if required. So you need to look at these things. And of course, CII, I already mentioned, 5,000 gross tonnage and above, A to E, five-tiered scale. Basically, a ship CII is calculated as ratio of the total mass of carbon dioxide emitted to the total transport work undertaken in a given calendar year. So you need to look at it that way. And if you just look at this, this makes it much clearer. Five ratings for the existing ships, A, B, C, D, E. This already we have talked about. D, three consecutive years, or E, shall develop a plan of corrective action. So if you see in this scale of A, B, C, D, E for existing ships, A is the best, B, all right, C is just on the border, D or E, corrective plans you need to do. Rating bands, they call it, and this will be added in your scene. And here I would like you to just have a look at 2023 EEXI certification work will go. They are comparing it with 2008. As you can see, CII is CO2 emission divided by capacity multiplied by the distance. And EEXI certification, scene purification with new addition, CII rating annual declaration. And the review class 2026-2030. So IMO's game plan is to keep a greenhouse gas emission reduction of CO2 almost about 40% from the shipping industry. This is actually MEPC 75. Now the 76 has come where they have brought out these amendments and new regulations. So you will also find there is a gradient in this ABCD rating. This gradient, that means what happens over the years, it keeps on reducing, that means, your CO2 emission by operating the ship, how you are going to, bring down the CO2 emission level. Here, if you just look at this, this particular slide is an interesting slide. I hope you are able to see. Now, proposed EEXI framework is more or less, it's going to be like this. IMO is giving you many guidelines. So if the ship is an existing ship, calculate energy efficiency performance, your EEXI attained to be calculated. How to calculate? The guidelines are given in IMO. And exactly, it is very similar to EEDI attained calculation. Okay, once it is done, now compare it with the required EEXI, which again IMO has set the benchmark as a reduction factor of your EEDI. Required EEDI, use the reduction factor, then you get your required EEXI that is set by IMO as the benchmark. And if your attained EEXI is meeting this value, that means you are all green, you are meeting. That means you carry out this, the survey is completed, your certificate, this certificate is International Energy Efficiency Certificate, is given to the ship. So efficient operation. So that's the, the existing ship is well within the emission limitation requirement. But the question is, if it is not meeting, if the required EEXI is more than the attained EEDI, then efficiency improvements are required. So shaft engine power limit, power optimization, or fuel change or energy saving devices, or replacement with new ships, or other verifiable options. This is how it's going to be. This is how So once the survey is carried out, in case if you are not meeting, that is why the grading, the rating they are giving, like, you know, if you get D or E or C, the ship owner has to look at what measures he will be able to take to bring down the CO2 emission. So, classification society surveys are being taken as consultant, and many shipping companies and ship managers already have started the work, so that even though we have 2022-2023, this is going to be a very important exercise for the existing ships to get the right rating and then to go on in the business. So, gentlemen, these are the new changes that has been brought in MARPOL Annex 6 through MEPC 76. So I thought I'll just discuss this issue with you all. So, gentlemen, thank you very much. I would like you to give feedback if you feel to put anything. Just put it in feedback at hamt.com. So, gentlemen, thank you very much.